this girl is feeling herself, okay? So this is my dance party that I'm doing now to promote wellness and mental health. I'm going to be doing it on Fridays, dancing for wellness, people. That's what it's about, wellness. So you should go take a look at this dance party video. It will make you smile probably, and then you can get up and dance with me. But it's all for us as a whole to get better mentally, because dance has been a big part of my wellness journey. I used to be a salsa dancer and I used to dance salsa a lot. So go check out that video and dance with me after this video. So if you've never seen any of my videos and you're here as a new person, I want you to know that I have OCD and anxiety. And all of my channel is about how I try to get well and how I try to improve myself in my wellness journey as a person who has a mental illness, right? So I want to encourage you today to think a little differently about yourself, because I talk a lot about the external things you can do to improve your anxiety. Like, I've tried CBD oil and I've tried acupuncture and I've tried so many different things, but there is a big part of how you think that will determine how well you move forward in your own mental health journey. Now, some of the things that have hindered me in my journey, I want to share with you. And so maybe if you're doing those things, you can stop and we can all move forward together and be well. So for many years, I walked around really thinking low of myself. Growing up in the Black community, I talk about all of the things that I encountered as far as being stigmatized in the Black community because of my mental illness and because of my mental health issues. And that greatly affected how I thought about myself. So for many years, I walked around thinking, something's wrong with me. I'm never going to be like the next person who's normal. I'm not going to be able to do this thing or that thing. I may not be able to be successful in a relationship. What do I have to give if I'm constantly ritualizing and doing compulsions and going over things in my head because of my OCD and all of these other negative self-talk things that I would say to myself that really hindered my progress forward. So I want to say to you today that if you are doing that and if you are stuck in the past of what has happened because of your mental health disorder, please come to the present and start here today from the present forward. Because if you walk around thinking of yourself as a victim of your own mind, you will be a victim of your own mind. And I don't want to be a victim of my mental health issue for the rest of my life. At some point, I want to think I'm a conqueror, right? I'm somebody who's pretty dope, if I can use that word. I don't even know if that's still trendy. That's me trying to be super cool. But I think of myself as very resilient now. Someone who probably has encountered things that the average person has not. And someone who is able to handle those things well because I have experienced the really lows of life to a certain extent. And so how you think about yourself is going to determine how you go forward. And if you're stuck in a history that you keep repeating to yourself, the mistakes you made, the things you didn't do, the things you did do that weren't so great, all of those things will keep you very stagnant. You have to come out of the past and all of the things that have happened to you, the trauma, the relapses, the horrible treatment by family members or friends or anything else that has happened to you because of your mental health issues. You have to let it go and leave it in the past. Start today and move present. And that doesn't mean you forget or that it doesn't hurt you. But at some point, the trauma of the past cannot continue, because if it does, you will not be able to move to the future. And if you're stuck stagnant, guess what happens? Time keeps moving without you. It doesn't stop. And before you know it, you look up, you're bitter, you don't have a life, You're still stuck in this negative self-talk. You haven't moved forward in your thinking. You haven't done anything or accomplished anything you want to accomplish because you're letting your brain and your mind limit you to what you can do. And then you're going to look up and you're going to look around you and time has moved. And you're still in your mind stuck in years ago, right? And you can't go back and change anything. So what does it help you to stay there? And I learned this lesson myself because there were so many times I was sitting thinking, oh, if I just had not done those rituals or compulsions because of my OCD, then I wouldn't have been stuck in that situation. And then I wouldn't have relapsed. And if I had just gotten on medication sooner, and maybe if I had went to a therapist longer, and what if I hadn't done that? Maybe I wouldn't have had that relapse. And then the thoughts come and it's like, well, what can I do about any of that? I can't. The only thing I can do something about is today, right? Today, I can try harder. Today, I can be more diligent about being well. Today, I can take the mistakes that I made and make some decisions that are better to move forward. That's all you can do. So stop walking around being a victim of your own mind. Let yourself heal from the past so that you can get to the future and actually have some kind of life for yourself. Another way that you can move forward and stop being a victim of your own mind is to really focus on who's around you in your space. There are people I know around some of you right now who are making you feel lower than you are because of your mental health issues. And either they're doing that because they're acting ashamed of you, right? Or they are talking negatively about what you encounter and go through. It's not right. And I want to tell you that if you have people around you like that, it's going to make your journey to wellness much harder. Because as much as you need to be diligent about thinking positively, the people around you who claim to love you should be doing the same when it comes to you and your mental health issues. They should be supportive. They should be caring. They should not be hiding. They should not be ashamed. And if they are doing any of those things will have an effect on how you feel about yourself. I know because growing up in the Black community, having a mental illness was not a good thing. It was something that was looked down upon, something that was shunned, something that people were ashamed of, didn't talk about. And if you had a family member who had a mental illness, it was a hush thing so that nobody else would know about it. You don't have to sit around and let other people make you feel ashamed. Why would you feel ashamed about something you don't even have control over? How about that? I don't get that. These are cards that have been dealt to us and we play the hand the best we can, right? We didn't ask for this. And I'm pretty sure that my OCD and anxiety is genetic. I will talk about that in another video. And no matter what kind of disorder you have, it is not your fault. And if there are any people around you who are making you feel ashamed at all, you should have a discussion with those people and explain to them how they are hurting you. And if you can't have a discussion or you feel like it's not even worth it, then you should move yourself away. So these are just some things that I've been thinking about. And I'm going to be doing more videos about this to encourage you all and encourage myself to move forward. Right? Let's not be victims of the past constantly for the rest of our lives. Let's move forward into wellness. Let's try, at least. You have to try. And it's hard. Sometimes you might need to go in and see a therapist to get rid of some trauma. Sometimes you might need to really start thinking about the things that are keeping you behind so that you can do something about it. Just giving it some thought. Whatever you have to do, do it and move forward. I will talk to you all next time. Please like and subscribe. Don't forget to check out my dance party for health video. I am dancing up a storm there, people. Go see it next time, people. Bye.